Someone's been sleeping in my bed. The eiderdown's on the floor, said the very, very big bear.
Someone's been sleeping in my bed. The pillow's all ruffled up, said the big, but not quite so big bear.
Someone's been sleeping in my bed, said the little bear. In fact, they still are.
Quickly, the other two raced around to see who'd been eating their porridge, sitting on their chairs and sleeping in their beds. Of course, it was Goldilocks, still fast asleep in the tiny wooden bed. The three bears looked at her, then at each other, then at Goldilocks again. The very, very big bear, not wanting to frighten the little girl, tapped her very gently on the shoulder. he said. Goldilocks slowly woke up and rubbed her eyes. She rolled over to see three furry faces looking at her. There was a very big furry face, a big but not quite so big furry face, and a furry face that couldn't quite see over the bed.
Help!
She said, and jumped out of the bed, out of the window, ran across the clearing, through the bracken, out of the forest, and home, without once looking behind her. The three bears watched her disappear through the trees.
If only she'd stayed, she could have helped make more porridge, said the very, very big bear.
If only she'd stayed, she could have helped mend the chair, said the big, but not quite so big bear.
If only she'd stayed, we could have gone out to play in the forest, said the baby bear, sadly.